Hi guys. Oh my gosh, welcome back to my channel. It is Katie. If it is your first time here, welcome. I have a very random all over the place channel, but one thing that I love to do is react to artists that I really, 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 really love and react to their music. And that list is pretty short. I primarily react to Taylor Swift. She is my queen. She's my number one. If you're a Swiftie in any way, shape, or form, hi, we are the same. The only other like second album I ever reacted to was Ari's Thank You Next album. I just had a good feeling about it and I'm so happy. I love that album so much. And then I think the only other one I've done is Selena Gomez's Rare album, which is good. I enjoy it. Taylor's still my queen and Ari, whatever. I have seen Ariana only once in concert, but I really love her. I'm wearing my Sweetener World Tour merch right now, and we are here to react to Positions, the album. So much love and respect to her for releasing an album, like, never over the fact that she released two albums within 6 months. I love that Taylor did that, basically-ish, with Lover and Folklore, but Ari did it first. So anyway, point being, I'll try to stop mentioning Taylor, but point being, I haven't listened to this yet because I've been wanting to film it and now is the time. So I haven't listened to any of it except for Positions, her first single, and I have tried to stay away from like reviews or spoilers or anything. Breaking news, you guys, I got a new Bose speaker. So I do still have the trusty teal one that I've used in every other video, but this is new and improved. It's probably gonna get dirty real fast because it's white, but that's okay. Okay, so track one is called Shut Up, and it's explicit, which, love that about Ari. I have no idea what to expect, literally zero, except for that the Positions video is sick and amazing, and all of the imagery from this, oh, I'm here for it. All of her looks and her, like, yeah, okay. Shut up. Shut up, Katie. Here for it, okay? Cinematic. Guess if I can just click one night, all them demons help me see shit differently. So don't be sad. Now you sound so dumb. So dumb? You sound so dumb. You sound so dumb. Oh, I love that, like violin. Maybe you should shut up. Or like just the, that strings element. If only you would shut up. How you be spending your time, huh? How you be using this is very time, like you be so white, Ari, but also lots of unique down elements. I love her calling somebody so dumb. We all want to say that sometimes. Living for the background. Ooh, I really like that. Stop. Yep. Movie. So theatrical. Oh, that's the end. Okay, that was cool. Oh. Taylor, what are you doing here? Oops, my music must have been on shuffle. That was super cool. Admittedly, I feel like I liked the production and like the background and the a little bit even more than just the song itself. Or, you know what I mean? But yeah, cool. Liked it. The next one is called 34 plus 35, which I'm pretty sure is her new single, right? She just put out a video for this. So again, I haven't listened to any of this, so I'm stoked. Explicit mark, but that's not shocking for her at all. So what you doing tonight? Better stay doing you right. I don't wanna keep you up, you. But show me, can you keep it up? Cause then I'll have to keep you up. I've been drinking coffee. I've been drinking coffee. And I've been eating healthy. And I've been eating happy. No one gets squeaky. No one gets squeaky. Baby, I'm an energy. Stay up all night. Cute. Fuck me till the daylight. Dirty. 30 for 35. I love her. Is it clear what the 34 plus 34 5 is? Like, should I be trying to decipher that? Except this wine. Can you stay up all night? Fuck me till Very danceable. Ari! I don't understand what 34, 35. Ariana Grande. Oh my God. Oh my God. Wow, Ari. Well played. Did we catch that, people? It means I want a 69 with you. Math class. I am mind blown. That was so clever. Wow. Also, was that her dirtiest song to date? Yes or no? I feel like it is, but oh my God, I'm so shook by that. Okay, I need to watch the video. Okay, next we have Motive with Doja Cat. Let's go. Whoa. Tell me why I get this. I could go bullshit out from a mile away. This is good, it's dancey, it's catchy, but it's not like, you know, when does Doja Cat come in? I'm assuming now. Yep. You feel me like gold, baby. Now you wanna spoil me, did you wanna trophy? Any other bombs you're gonna drop at the end here, girl? Okay, so we're just keeping it super real so far. We have Shut Up, 34 plus 35, Motive. I like it all a lot, but I don't, like, love any of it yet. I loved Thank You Next. I loved that album. Quick, brief history of my Arianator-ness that nobody asked for is that I really, really love her first album. I don't know all of Dangerous Woman that well. Probably A Cardinal Sin. Is there another one in there that I'm missing? But then I know the Sweetener album very well, love it, and then I love the Thank You Next album. So anyway, I don't know all that there is to know with Ari, but yeah, I'm impressed. So far, I'm just not like shook. Mine is that last lyric. Next is called Just Like Magic. I love the name. It's our fourth explicit track in a row. Sounds like a video game or something. Then I ride to the studio, listening to some shit I wrote. To compromise, take my pen and write some love letters to heaven. Take my pen and write some love letters to heaven. That's to Mac Miller. Okay. Yep. And I'm also just so far, based on the first 40 seconds of these lyrics, what I'm getting from it is just that she's like in a good place. She is doing things for her mental health. She mentioned like meditation and writing music and like listening to her own music, which indicates being like proud of it. And you know, so for that alone, like I'm just, oh, I'm stoked for her, but obviously the anything about Mac is just like really depressing, but oh, I'm liking this. Okay. Middle finger to who? Love that. Yes! Stop, 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 stop. This is the one. This is where I'm starting to really get it. These lyrics are speaking to me. I send them love and light. Like, Wow. Wow, wow, wow. I love her referencing like books. I mean, this very much speaks like quarantine to me and just that journey and how she's rich and famous, and but she's trying to stay connected and grounded. And she said middle fingers to somebody, which I hope she repeats again in the chorus, because I need to hear like who we flipping off, because I'm, yeah, who we throwing middle fingers to, because I'm ready. I have a list. And I love her talking about attracting what she wants. Just like magic. Oh, I like that audio clip. Just like magic. Middle finger to my thumb, and then I slap it. That's what she said, right? I'm over here thinking we're like, we have beef with somebody, but I guess that's just me. Front runner for now. Like, loved the lyrics, loved it. Here for it. Next is our first non-explicit track. It's called Off the Table with The Weeknd. Sounds like it could be sexy, but there's no explicit again, so okay.
Ooh.
See, there's like a sensualness to this, though. Is that a clock? Stop. Will I ever love somebody like the way I did you? Ugh. Never thought you'd be so damn hard to replace. Ugh. I swear it to me, there's love completely on the table. Okay. Okay. Yep. Yep. And wait for the next line. Yep. 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 Okay, Ari. Yep, there's my girl. If I can't have you, is love completely off the table? I relate to that. Oh my god. Oh my god. And she's probably talking about Mac. Woo! Will you be there? Am I too cold? Oh my god. I'm so freaking. Oh my god, you guys. I'll wait for you. Okay, but I kind of wish. I kind of wish it was just Ari. No shade to The Weeknd, but like. I just want the woman's perspective. But that in and of itself shows you that I am like cold and kind of like, is love off the table? Because I think I'm pretty hardened to the world at this point. But am I totally insane or is this reminding me of like Beauty and the Beast? Anybody following that track? Don't hate me, but it's like just the tiniest dash of cheesiness, being that it's like the two of them together. And I think that was bringing me to like a, I do love this. It's over though. That's bringing me to like a Disney movie type place. But I mean, I really liked that. And I really loved the lyrics, the meaning, like all that kind of stuff. I feel like that was probably inspired by Mac Miller. I mean, what do I know? And then, but then isn't she in a new relationship? I feel like she is. I hope she is. I want her to be happy. And so I maybe The Weeknd was kind of playing the role of like, look, I'm not him. But love doesn't have to be off the table. Like, I don't know. That's, I liked it. Next one is called 630, and we're back to explicit. Yeah, I know I'll be on some bullshit. No, I'll be driving you crazy. But I know you love how I whip it. You could only stay mad for a minute. Aww. So even if one day I lose it and go crazy, I know that shit kinda heavy. I like that this is now calling out, like, his side, his perspective. Like, I'm on my BS sometimes, but, like, so are you. So I'm curious to see how the 630 lyric is gonna come into play. While I'm here in an awkward standstill, oh, my hand hurts. I'm gonna hit pause and go refresh my drink. BRB. Okay, okay. Back to it. 630. You know you be on some bullshit. Act so possessive and crazy. Crazy. Ugly. I like that. Not scared to show somebody you're ugly. 630. Are you down? What's up? Are you down? I'm still waiting. It's 6:30. Oh, you still have a crush? Who is she dating? The guy from the Stuck With You video, right? Who? Somebody educate me. So 6:30 is saying like, that's when the sun goes down? I mean, not as strong of like a number analogy as the 34 plus 35, but woo! That was cute. I like that. Very cute. Next we have Safety Net featuring Ty Dolla Sign. No explicit mark. Whoa! In the peace with my path. Tripping, falling with no safety net. Ah. Yep. Ooh, okay, 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 okay. Shout out, lyric check in my head off Thank You Next. I'm liking this. I'm liking this. Like, I had made peace with my past, but what the heck is this? And, like, I'm tripping, you know, being, like, doing this whole thing is, like, tripping and falling without a safety net. Is this real? Like, okay, I'm here for, like, all this relatable content. Go on. Fight or flight, is that what she said? Some cool, like, weird production sounds. Cool and weird. Oh, there's still a minute left. Vibe. Yeah, I liked that. That was fun. Next we have My Hair. I'm sorry. Alexa, I wasn't talking to you. No explicit mark, it's called My Hair. Ooh! What's happening? I dig this. Kind of has like a jazzy blues vibe. Mariah Carey or something. Like, I don't know why. It just gives me a vibe. Also, I have Ari hair today, kind of. Super fun. I dug that. Short, sweet, fun, cute. Okay, next track is called Nasty. Explicit mark. Oh my god. That beginning reminds me of The Way with Mac Miller, like her original single. No? Just saying. I love her laugh. She's so cute. I do love how unapologetic she is with her sexuality. Bit repetitive, but I mean, it's a vibe. Okay, fam, we have a few more. Next up is called West Side. It's not an explicit track. I live for like the unique, weird effects. They catch my attention. It also gives me that kind of vintage-y, like R&B vibe. I don't know why I said vintage, but like 90s. Aw, but your wife? Cute! I really do like the R&B kind of atmosphere. Sure. I was trying to have a synonym for vibe, because it's an overused word, but I love it. It's an R&B vibe. That song was very short and sweet. Like, yeah, that was probably the shortest one on the album so far. Okay, next song is called Love Language, and it does have an explicit. Oh my gosh! Now I'm getting like disco vibes. There, I said vibes again. Background. It's inspiring me to do like all kinds of like, I don't even know what kind of dance moves. So it's a unique sound and I'm here for that. Is it really just gonna fade for 30 seconds? Head over my shoes like wool. Know you like an inside joke. Running cause you just must be. That's the one in the slow. No, she ain't just gonna let it fade for 30 seconds. She's gonna hit us with that. Okay, next is Positions, which we've heard. Let's just give it like a cute little second. Heaven, inside joke to me. Okay, Positions in and of itself like has grown on me a lot since the first initial listen. It grew with each listen, so I'm actually feeling that for most of this album, but Positions is great. Next we have Obvious, which is the last explicit track. I'm praying we don't budget, I know you're the real thing when you walk through the door. Me, oh my love. I like this part. Oh, that's the end of that one too. It's a short track. That was cute. Very catchy. And yeah, I'm really getting that, like, now I'm gonna go extensively research her love life. Oh, wait. Okay. We're on the last track, you guys, and it is called POV, which I'm assuming means point of view. And there's no explicit mark, so is it gonna be a ballad maybe? I don't know. I feel like there were no ballads, just like some more deep bops, but like it was pretty consistently like boppy and dancey, you know what I mean? Oh, maybe this is a ballad. It already just sounds sweet. I'm basing that off of 10 seconds of notes. Oh my god. Turn my minutes into hours. You got more than 2020, babe. trust me. I really like that. This feels like it could be on her first album. What was that album called? Shoot. The one with, I know. You, like, real true Arianators are yelling at me. Yours truly. This feels like this could be on this album. Okay, I'm digging this. Sorry, I'm looking up her boyfriend. Because he sounds great. I really like this. Is that rain? Oh, it was kind of somewhat of an abrupt end. There we go back to my tears ricochet. Wow, you guys, positions. Okay. This is gonna take some time to process, to re-listen to it. Her vocals are flawless. That's to be expected. And I overall really enjoy it. I want to keep listening. But for me personally, I'm such a lyric girl. The ones that really kind of had some of those deeper, meaningful lyrics are where I really started feeling connected and getting hooked with the album. With that said, I'm immediately going to go watch the 34 plus 35 video. I'm going to go stalk her boyfriend and, like, watch some of my favorite reaction people's reaction videos to this, like AJ. What is her last name? Something with a P. AJ, and then, like, Dante D'Angelo, I think. Let me give them proper credit. Just AJ. AJ2 is, I don't know. And then Dante D'Angelo. So let me know what you guys think of this album. What's your favorite song? I feel like I really liked, let's see. Positions is obviously a great song. And 34 plus 35 was mind-blowing. Just Like Magic. I really liked Just Like Magic. I liked Off the Table. I liked My Hair a lot. I liked Love Language, POV, Safety Net. Like, it was all super good. So I'm going to have to keep listening. And I'll see you next time, guys. I would love you if you would subscribe, especially if you too love Taylor Swift, because we love Taylor. We love Ari. We love a lot of pop queens around here. So, okay, I'm going to shut up. Goodbye. I love you.